So several months ago, I decided I would begin recording with video my enjoyment of this hobby, the hobby of historical and conflict gaming. So my enjoyment of this hobby includes counters and hexes, miniatures like these, miniatures and rulers, and in some cases even pixels and keyboards. So this is another installment in my documentary here. This is another ship-on-ship duel using the Star Trek HeroClix tactics game system. We're going to do a little bit of pre-game preparation, but just a little bit. So we have another Federation ship, the USS Equinox, against the IKS Chitung. We'll go through kind of a side-by-side comparison of each in preparation. So they're both a 75-point ship, 75-point and 75 points, so they are rated to be roughly equal. So this should be a an equal fight here, or close to it anyways. And go with the Equinox here. Instead of going through all of the powers and abilities on the ship card, which if you're going to get serious about this game, you would certainly want to do that. And I'll say now, I may never get into this system in any full-time way. I don't know how else to put it, but if you're really interested in you know, Star Trek ships, ship combat, fast play, with a lot of narrative, what's the best way to put it? A lot of narrative value to your amount of gaming time put in. I think that you could definitely do worse than this game system, and I think you I would think that you shouldn't have too hard a time finding people to play face to face and in competitions or what have you. Okay, but what I'm going to do is I'm just going to review the powers that are active right now as kind of a, I don't know, a halfway measure, instead of doing some type of an intense study up on all these, all the powers and abilities for each ship. So let's do also, at the same time that we're going to review the powers that are active, we'll also do a side-by-side analysis. So the range value again is that number next to the lightning bolt. So the Equinox has a range of 6 and 1 lightning bolt, as compared to the Chitung range of 8 and also 1 lightning bolt. So at the top, obviously they're both winged flyers because they're ships. The Equinox has a movement value of 10, and you see the gray background there behind the movement value of 10. There it is. So we look down here. So the movement power and ability in effect right now for the Equinox is nucellogenic charged warp or running shot. So remember, he can do a half move and shoot. Over here, movement value of the Chitung is just a bit slower. It's 9 instead of 10. And that 9 has a kind of a brownish background. Yeah, that is a brown background. Or at least it looks brown on the dial there anyways. There it is. So a movement value of 9, speed of 9, with a brown background. So in effect right now is this one right here at the top, hit and run tactics. So that's hypersonic speed. Real quick. Hypersonic speed, that's this one right here on the powers and abilities card. Give this character power action, move it up to its speed value. It automatically breaks away and can use the Running Man Infinity. I'm still not 100% on, you know, have my head around all these symbols, but I do appreciate, in general, I appreciate game systems that employ universal type symbols. But anyways, during this move, this character may, as a free action, make one close combat or ranged attack with its range value halved for the attack. Okay, so basically he's doing a move, and sometime during the move he can make a close combat or a half ranged attack. That's pretty cool. Okay, so hit and run tactics, that makes sense, right? Okay, back to the Equinox. Has a attack value of 9 with no powers and abilities associated. So 9, that is about average, or slightly below average. The Chitong has a 10 attack value, no powers and abilities associated with it at this time. So the Chitong right now is going to have a slightly better ability to hit the Equinox than vice versa. Back to the Equinox, has a defense value of 17 with a kind of orange background. So that is this right here, the orange defense power and ability, multiphasic shielding or toughness. That again is toughness right there. So under defense, toughness, damage dealt to this ship is reduced by 1. Okay, that's good. And then 17, not a bad defense at all, I think. Over here to the Chitong, it also has a defense value of 17, and it also has an orange background. So it has, right there, raised deflectors, also toughness. So each of these ships at this point, at this damage level, each of these ships will be reducing their damage by 1 in general. Okay, back to here to, again, also the Equinox. Next to the little explosion symbol there on the dial base, we have next to it a 2. We have a 2 with a black background there. So look on the, there it is. Black damage symbol, breaking the prime directive, outwit. Okay, this is going to be, this is something to pay attention to up front. So we're going to go to under damage, under the black damage symbol, outwit. During your turn, give this ship a free action to counter a power or combat ability possessed by a single target opposing character until the beginning of your next turn. So basically, outwit is going to allow the Equinox to nullify one for free, one power or combat ability possessed by the Chitong. This can be pretty significant. But the Equinox needs to be within 10 squares and line of fire of the Chitong to not nullify that combat ability or power. Now, I'm assuming, at least in general, I'm assuming that by power here, using this breaking the prime directive ability, the Equinox is going to nullify one of those basically colored values on the combat dial, or combat ability, I'm assuming, is, what is combat ability exactly? I understand maybe attack, but how do you nullify the defense, for example? So it says combat ability. Combat ability possessed by a single target. So we have, looking in the glossary to start with, we have combat dial, which is basic, upon which the character's powers and combat values are printed. So combat values, the 4 numbers visible through the stat slot on a character's combat dial, and the number next to the lightning bolts on the character's base. So by that, combat values are these 3, the move, attack, defense, damage, and the range of 8. So So it's all those, okay. But now what are combat abilities? What are combat abilities? What's an ability? An ability is a capability possessed by a ship, indicated by a symbol on its base, and or explained on its character card. Okay, so are all abilities combat abilities? So let's look at the rules section. Powers and abilities. Powers are always printed on a combat dial, are visible through the stat slot, and are either standard powers or special powers. Okay, by the way, that's the black bordered white squares. Special powers. I was wondering about that before. I don't think either of these ships have. No, neither of these ships have these, but now I know for the future that those black bordered white squares are special powers. Combat abilities? There we go. Combat ability. Because breaking the prime directive, core rule is outwit. Counters a power or combat. By the way, what does counter mean? Does counter have a counter? A game effect that causes another power, ability, or effect to no longer be possessed by a ship. Okay. Yeah. In effect, nullify, right? Okay. Combat abilities. Abilities are always indicated by a symbol on the character's base, never on the combat dial. On the character's base. These symbols grant certain abilities to your character that they possess at all times. Okay. Okay, so combat abilities are indicated by specific combat symbols on the base of the ship next to the stat slot. They are explained on the powers and abilities card. So it's on the base of the character next to the stat slot. Oh, combat abilities. Summarized on the play card. Okay. Different combat symbols indicate the type of character and the combat abilities it possesses. So you're nullifying one of these. So does that mean you're nullifying movement or nullifying attack or nullifying defense or damage? I guess that's what it means. That is a powerful ability, I guess. During your turn, give this ship a free action to counter a power or a combat ability possessed by a single target opposing ship until the beginning of your next turn. A ship unit powers. During your turn. So during your turn, you counter its. But if you counter its defense, then you're going to automatically hit it when you attack. So one more time, the combat abilities. Unless they mean these combat abilities. Oh, I think they mean these combat abilities. Not that you nullify a defense or an attack, but you nullify these ones. So, is there a merge? Oh, there is a merge. I mean, paid attention to this. Okay. So you're nullifying one of these in this one of these So if the and the equinox, I was wondering about that. I was wondering why the Chitong has a has an empty shield and the equinox has a shield with the line through it. And these are two distinct things. So there's a standard defense and there's the indomitable defense. So with this outwit power, I think you would be nullifying this combat ability, which is described here. Carry, colossal stamina, duo attack, etc. So we would look and we would see yeah, there's indomitable and there's merge. Okay. That's what it is. I'm going to keep all that straight. Okay. All right, and back to the Chitong. It also has a damage value of 2, same as the Equinox, and it has a green behind it. So we look at the ship card, and is right there. General Martok's orders. There's Martok again. He's everywhere. Enhancement. So under damage, right there. Damage, we have enhancement. When an adjacent friendly character makes a range con. Okay. All right, this isn't gonna matter here because it's just one ship on one ship, so there will never be another friendly ship next to the Chitong in this battle. Okay. All right, now we get started. Went over the basics there. A little bit of a analysis, very closely matched. Fight actually very closely matched. The Chitong has range, a slight range advantage. Equinox has a slight move advantage. The Chitong has a slight attack advantage. Yeah. And the Equinox still has that outwit power. All right. So start with the Equinox. Same corners I've been using. The Federation player rolls a 6. And the Klingon player rolls a 7. So the Klingon player will go first. Has that hit and run tactics, but not allowed to make an attack against the Equinox. If the Chitong can, he's not allowed to actually make that attack on the first turn before the Equinox has taken an action. So he will move up to his. He has 9. He'll move 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and then stop in the hindering terrain. So this hindering terrain here, maybe this is, asteroid belt or something here. But it is slightly different coloration, slightly different coloration here, and you see the green lines identifying the hindering terrain there. So the Chitong takes a move, gets an action token for that move, and it goes to the Equinox. So he has that mucilaginic charged warp. But the Chitong is in hindering terrain. He has a movement of 10. He'll move over to the next to that star if he can reach there. So he'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Right, so they are clearly in striking range of each other, each in hindering terrain. The Equinox gets an action token and back to the Chitong. Not going No. I don't think. Well, we certainly didn't review any power that allows him to avoid pushing damage. So, make sure I don't miss anything again. He will. Then again, he could also simply close the distance. He'll clear his action token. And then back to the Equinox. Does the Equinox now risk pushing? Does have the. So half of its move is 10, so half of its move would be 5. Its range is 6. He'll do this. He's going to use his he's going to use that Nucellogenic charged warp to move. And this will be pushing damage. He will take that. So he halves his speed to 5. He's going to go out of the hindering terrain. 1, 2, 3 has to stop because he enters hindering terrain again. And then he gets a ranged attack for free. Yes, free. So range is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's within its range of 6. Just a standard attack with that attack value of 9. Ooh, 9 plus 10, 19. Okay, so 19. Again, the defense of the Chitong is 17. And it has that toughness, so damage will be reduced by 1. But he hits because he has 19, which is greater than or equal to 17. Oh yeah. So we take his damage value of 2 right there next to the explosion symbol, -1 for the Chitung's raised deflectors. So he takes one click of damage. So the Chitong is now, see what has changed. Okay, so actually, yep, and something did change. We take a look here. So what changed? So I think his attack value, yeah, his attack value dropped by 1 to 9. His movement value is 8, which I think dropped. Anyways, it's 8, but now it changed to a new color. It's kind of a, oh, it's a different shade of tan, which is now cavalry raid running shot. So now he has ability to do a half move and a ranged shot. His defense 17, red still, so that's the same. Wait a minute. Oh, no, I'm sorry, that's changed too. So now it's 17 red, which is this one, cloaking device. Want to check that out. Cloaking device. Right here, defense. Right there. So it's cloaking device in parentheses, super senses right here. When this ship is hit by an attack, you may roll a d6. May, okay. I'll talk about that in just a second. You may roll a d6 before damage is dealt. On a result of 5 to 6, this ship evades the attack. That's nice. Now, may. I talked about this in an earlier video. We do go by may or the absence of may. If may is not given in the powers and abilities description, then it is required. It's not optional. So I talked about this before about whether a ship could choose not to institute its powers and abilities. So the answer, it is spelled out in the rules. I hadn't found it earlier, but now I did. You do go by may or the absence of may. So this is a choice. Some of these other powers and abilities do not include may, in which case they are in effect. If they're showing in the dial, they are in effect, and they're not optional. Okay, so he took 1 point of damage, and now he has some different abilities. The Equinox, though, pushed, so he takes a click of pushing damage. Alright, so now what's changed on the Equinox? It's not very easy to see, but movement dropped 1 to 9, but it's against a dark blue background. Sometimes it looks black, but that's actually dark blue, which is right there. We're going home. Plasticity. This one's pretty interesting if I remember. Plasticity. So under speed, plasticity. This ship adds 2 to its d6 roll when breaking away. Opposing ships subtract 2 from their d6 roll when breaking away from this ship. That's pretty significant. So that makes them more nimble, so to speak. In effect, I think that makes the Equinox more nimble. Oh, and the rest of them, his attack, I think, dropped 1 to 8. Defense dropped, I think, 1 to 16. Now it's still multiphasic shielding. Okay, and the damage, I think that green is, yeah, the green is new. So he no longer has the outwit, the breaking the prime directive. So that powerful one is out of play now, or for now, I should say, because nothing's automatic, I guess. Damage is still 2, which is good. Don't want to drop that right there. And it now has that kind of lime green background, so we have that right there. So it is EMH. Mark 1, ethical subroutines deleted. Exploit weakness. That sounds interesting. Damage. So there it is, and here it is. Give this ship a close combat action. Damage from the attack is penetrating damage, which means something along the lines of cannot be evaded or avoided, or nearly so anyways. We'll look it up when that's in play. All right, so the Equinox is back there. It has 2 action tokens. That was a good roll. Back to the Chitong. What do they want to do? Probably should exploit. Yeah, they're going to exploit their running shot, their cavalry raid. So that is a half move and a shot. Half move and a shot. So his movement is 8. So half move is going to be 4. And then a shot. Range is always 8. So we'll go. Yeah, the Chitong can more easily get out of the range of the Equinox. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8. Let's do that. So the Chitong is going to go 1, 2, 3, 4 to the edge of the map here. So that's half of his move. Oh, wait a minute. Sorry, I keep forgetting. Before, when you leave hindering terrain, I keep forgetting this, you will have your movement just for leaving the hindering terrain. So I guess that would be two halvings, right? Have first for leaving hindering terrain, have again for the ability of cavalry raid. So let's do it this way. So it's going to be 1, 2. You got to remember that. Leaving hindering terrain, kind of have your movement. I should say it's not even leaving hindering terrain, exiting, starting your move with exiting a hindering terrain square halves your move to begin with. Okay, now is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So he is within range of the equinox. He will do a standard attack. He doesn't have anything but a base 9 attack right there. Wow. My first box car in a while. So let's do the okay, so damage. Your damage is 2. Check on that critical hit. Critical hit. I think it's what is it? Like doubles the damage or makes it penetrating damage or something. There it is. Rolling 2 and 12, critical misses and critical hits. If you roll a 12 on an attack roll, you automatically hit the target, regardless of what you needed to roll to hit. This is called a critical hit. A critical hit increases damage dealt by 1 to each successfully hit target. Okay, so increase 1, which I guess is good for the Chitong in this case because the Equinox still has the multiphasic shielding, so that would reduce the damage by 1, but the critical hit raises it back up to 2. So the Equinox takes 2 damage. Wow. All right, that critical hit came probably at a very important time. I think that right there significantly puts the or unbalances this fight because the Chitong is still at damage level 2. The Equinox is now at 4. We want to review now because quite a few things have changed on its ability, powers, and abilities. Movement is now 8. So now it no longer has any move advantage over Chitong. 8 red. So we can't let them stop us now. There it is. We can't let them stop us now. Flurry right there is give this ship a close combat action after the close combat attack resolves. It may make a second close combat attack as a free action. Nice. If this ship loses flurry before it makes the second attack, it can't make the second attack. Wow, that's nice. So basically, a double close combat attack. Nice. The attack value is now 9, which is the same as Chitong, but it has a black power and ability. So right there, survival by any justifiable means, steel energy. Steel energy is right here. Each time an opposing ship takes damage from a close combat attack made by this ship, heal this ship of 1 damage. Wow. That could be significant. So okay. Defense is now 16, which is 1 lower than Chitong, and it's the lime green there. So seal interior compartments, combat reflexes. combat reflexes right here, defense. Modify this ship's defense value by +2 against close combat attacks. When this ship takes damage from an attack, it may choose to be knocked back. That's interesting. This character ignores knockback damage. All right, and damage is 2. And did it pick up its... It did. It picked up breaking the prime directive again. So now it's back to having the outwit power. Okay, so sometimes, I mean, I talked about how these powers change as you go down, and I guess you can also say up the dial, but sometimes these powers go and then they come back at a lower damage level, okay? So in any case, he's at damage level 4, though. The Chitong gets a action token for that that cavalry raid. All right, so back to the Equinox. Now I wonder if he shouldn't use his breaking the prime directive. He could counter, if anything, he could counter the cavalry raid, right? Counter a power or a combat ability. Power or a combat ability. What is a power again? Power is all those colored markers, right? Character special abilities. Powers are represented by a character's combat on a ship's combat dial by colored squares. So can't he, and it's for free, it's a free action. Oh, no, he is within 10 squares and he's within line of fire. So I think he's going to do that. He's going to use breaking the prime directive for free. The Equinox, oh, that's interesting. If he uses a free action, can he clear? Go to clearing damage, right? Clearing marker. Clearing action tokens. Did not receive... Okay. The operative concept is did not receive an action token this turn. It's a free action, so he's not receiving an action token. So I think he can use a free action. So he'll use breaking the prime directive to nullify, we'll just say nullify the Chitong's cavalry raid. So that'll be until the beginning of his Equinox's next turn. So we'd have to remember Chitong does not have cavalry raid. And now he clears action tokens. Yeah, and then we go back to the Chitong. Now the Chitong does not have... Oh, now he would have to do pushing. If he wanted to fire again... does he risk pushing damage? Does he risk pushing damage? He has the cloaking device, though. He has cloaking device. So basically he has extra defense. Do you or don't you? Okay. All right, he'll clear his action token. Back to the Equinox. So now, if breaking the prime directive is a free action, I guess he would do that every turn. So again, he's going to go, it's at the start of his turn, right? It just says during the turn. During the turn. That's interesting. So does that mean... I guess he's going to nullify the Chitung's cavalry raid again. I'll do that again because it's free. Oh, maybe he takes a shot now because he has that. Oh, that's close combat. Does he want to move into close combat? That would be interesting. Looks one, two, three. He can't close in. When he leaves the hindering terrain, he's going to have half of his movement value of 8, so he's only going to have 4. His range is only 6. 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, the Chitong's out of range right now anyways. I forget the Equinox has that short range of 6. He's going to move into close combat. He's going to move in for close combat in the future. He'll try. So he leaves the hindering terrain, so he has a movement of 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Takes an action token, and it's back to the Chitung. But the Chitung does not have cavalry raid. Does he just try to blast at this range? Why wouldn't he, actually? Why wouldn't he? Yeah, just fire. So it's a 9. 9 plus a 2d6 roll. Wow, 9. That's nice. 9 plus 9 is 18. Alright, 9 plus 9, 18. The defense of the Equinox is 16, so it clearly goes over. But we have to remember that the Equinox has the seal interior compartments. Modify this ship's defense value by +2 against close combat attacks. When this ship takes damage from an attack, it may choose to be knocked back. Yeah. So I guess it hits, but it's still minus. Is it minus one for? Well, no, it doesn't have toughness anymore. It doesn't have multiphasic shielding. It only has the combat reflexes. If he chose to take. So the Chitung is going to deal 2 damage unless the Equinox activated seal interior compartments. So knock back. When a player rolls doubles on a successful attack roll, the target is knocked back after any damage taken from the attack is applied. I guess I was supposed to do that when I rolled the boxcars. Knockback represents a ship being thrown backward by the force of an attack. A knockback, a ship is moved back 1 square for each damage taken. Man, he doesn't want that. Yeah. Let's skip that. I don't know about that. Well, he's dealing 2 damage to the Equinox. Equinox is now at damage level 6. And we'll take a look at his situation now, his stats now. So he has a, his movement's only 6 now. But he still has, we can't let them stop us now. Because it's a red 6. It's a 6 red. We can't let them stop us now stays. So his idea of closing the distance for close combat will continue. His attack is a 10. It's a black 10. So that's survival by any justifiable means. Okay. Defense is now 14, but he still has seal interior compartments. And he's still causing 2 damage, but that's it. Just plain 2 damage. Nothing else. Okay. So the Chiton takes a action token for that ranged attack. Now it's back to the Equinox. Equinox cannot take any pushing damage at all, so he has to clear his action. But he still, well, actually before that, he still gets to, he doesn't have the, breaking the prime directive anymore. So he just clears his action token. Back to the Chiton. Now the Chiton could, Chiton is still way up at 2, at the second, or damage level 2. He has a lot to spare. He could definitely, well, now he could use Cavalry Raid. He has Cavalry Raid, and Equinox is not able to nullify it. So half of his move would be 4, then he gets a range shot. Well, of course he's going to do that. So this will deal pushing damage. So he goes 1, 2, 3, 4. There's no way to I guess he'll move 1 into the hindering terrain and then shoot at let's go 1, 2 into the hindering terrain. Then he gets to ranged shot, ranged attack. Still has an attack value of 9 with nothing, no modifiers. Wow, he's been rolling really good this whole game. That is a 9 plus 9 is 18, which is definitely, yeah, it's definitely above the 14 defense value of Equinox. I don't think seal interior compartments is going to save. Unless. Oh, okay, now I think the I understand combat reflexes or seal interior compartments. I think he's, okay, so the Chiton would deal 2 damage, which means that the Equinox can choose to be knocked back 2 squares, and because of the power, he takes no knockback damage, which is what he has to do to survive. Because he can't risk taking a single hit. I think that's what it is. So now the Chiton takes a second action token and takes pushing damage. So we'll quickly take a look what's changed. Movement is 8. He has hit and run tactics. His attack 9, defense is 16, red, so he still has cloaking device. Okay, and nice. And then 2 damage and Joel Martyr's orders. Okay, so Not bad. Still fully in the fight here. All right, so we go back to the equinox. I mean, really, what does the equinox do? Well, what does he do? Well, let's see if he can survive close combat to use his. We can't let them stop us now. It's somewhat suicidal, of course, but so he will. Yeah, he'll use an action to move. 1, 2, 3. So now he's adjacent to the Chitong. Takes an action mark, action token. Back to the Chitong. The Chitong is going to clear action tokens. Back to the Equinox. Equinox cannot risk pushing damage, so he clears his action marker token. And back to the Chitong. Now the Chitong can use his hit and run tactics. He's just going to what he's going to do, yep, he's going to risk a straight, just try to, wait a minute, no, that's, I'll try and attack. He rolls a 6, oh, but it's also doubles. Well, that doesn't matter. I mean, that would be knocked back, but it doesn't matter because Equinox has that power, which I think is going to will supersede that anyways. So 6 plus 9 is 15, which is still greater than the Equinox's defense of 14. Oh, no. His defense is plus 2 against close combat attacks, so it's actually 16. 15 against defense of 16 is not enough. The Chitong actually misses. This is because of the seal interior compartment's power of the Equinox in close combat. So he gets an action token. Now it's back to the Equinox. Now the Equinox is going to try. Boy, he's now has a combat value of 10. He should really. Yes. And he has survival by any justifiable means. So he is definitely going to. Make a close attack against the Equinox, against the Chitong. Make sure, yeah. Okay, so here, Equinox rolls a 8, a respectable 8, plus an attack of 10 is 18. Now it has survival by any justifiable means. Okay, we'll have to go through the order here. First of all, 8 plus 10 is 18, which is greater than the Chitong's 16 defense of 16. But the Chitong also has cloaking device. So I'm not exactly sure about the order, but I'll just go in the order that I think of these things. So the Chitong has the cloaking device. So the Chitong gets to roll a 6-sided die. On a 5 or a 6? Nope, he rolled a 3. He does not evade. He does not evade the attack. So then it's going to. So 18 is more than 16, which would be a hit. So we go back to the Equinox, which deals 2 damage. There's nothing extra there, but it did have a black around the 10, which is the steel energy. Okay. Each time an opposing ship takes damage from a close combat attack made by this ship, heal this ship 1 damage. And right there, he's going to deal damage to the Chitong, so he heals 1 damage. Wow. So he's back up to damage level 5. Interesting. And the Chitong takes the original 2 damage. So the Chitong is at damage level 5, so Equinox is now at 5, having healed 1 damage. So now, suddenly, the fight has evened up. I think I got everything there. Equinox takes an action token. Wow. Now would be the time, I think, for the Chitong to risk pushing to, yeah, to hit the Equinox. So the can he use Cavalry Raid? Oh, he can. Oh, but then he has to attempt a breakaway. Maybe not. Maybe he just stays in close combat. All right. He won't consider Cavalry Raid, and he will just attack at close range. An attack value of 8. And then we'll be taking pushing damage. Ooh. So that is 6. 6 plus 8 is 14, which is not enough to hit the Equinox defense now of 15. Right there, 15. Now it was doubles, so... But it was not a successful attack roll. So, done. Wow, that just plain missed. Chitong takes a second action token and pushing damage. So now the tables are really turned. Chitong is now in worse shape than the Equinox at damage level 6. Wow. Go back to the Equinox. So can the Equinox eke out? Well, he's not gonna risk pushing damage because he should get the next action. He clears his tokens, action tokens. Chitong clears his action tokens, and we're back to the Equinox. So the Equinox is gonna look at what. Now he has the we can't let them stop us now. Now he's in close combat. Excellent. He still has survival by any justifiable means and seal interior compartments. So he could actually win now. So first back, he's going to do a close combat action, which will cost him a action token. But he's going to use we can't let them stop us now, which is the double attack. When this ship is given a close combat action, like now, you may roll a d6 after making a successful attack roll. No, I'm reading the wrong place, sorry. Flurry. Give this ship a close combat action. After the close combat action attack resolves, it may make a second close combat attack as a free action. Yeah, so he has a combat value of 9 now. 9 plus 7. 16, but he also has the black attack. That's steel energy. Okay, so let's see if he hits. 16 is more than the Chitong's current defense of 15, but the Chitong has that red. Okay, that's the cloaking device. Okay, so he's definitely going to try to use the cloaking device, so he's going to roll one die. The Chitong rolls one die. He wants a fibrous. He gets a 6. So, on a result of 5 or 6, the ship evades the attack. Wow. So he evades the attack. Damage is not dealt. Since damage is not dealt, the Equinox does not steal energy. Yeah. But now we go back to a second close combat attack because of the... we can't let them stop us now. It's a free action. So he rolls a 9. 9 plus 9 is 18. That's going to be harder. So 18 is clearly above 15. But the Chitong gets to try to... Yeah, he rolls a 1, so he does not... His cloaking device does not work. Now the Equinox would deal his 2 points of damage. Right there, he would deal his 2 points of damage. Can the Chitong do it? No, Chitong can't do anything because he already tried to use his cloaking device. So the Chitong takes two levels of damage. And when we rotated it just one click to damage level 7, we get knocked out, destroyed. The fight is over. Even though the Chitong started off with a sizable lead, an advantage, or sizable advantage in the duel, the tables were turned, and the Equinox, which ended up at damage level 5, succeeded in using, we can't let them stop us now, to destroy the Chitong. Wow. And the Equinox would heal one more level, actually, because of steel energy. So, that was definitely the most dramatic duel recently.